Hello, I'm Ernie Hoppola, Chief of the King City Police Department. I'd like to briefly speak to you about our department and our future. It's been 4 years since a police levy was passed by you, our voters. King City has grown, and so has our department. We've added one full-time officer and two part-time officers to keep up with calls for service and community needs. Region-wide calls for service have increased, and the types of calls we're responding to have changed over the last 4 years. Our officers have been tasked with locating and cleaning up multiple transient and houseless camps, and that's not traditionally been an issue in King City. There's been a 55% increase in calls involving someone in a mental health crisis since 2014, and the numbers are going up. We've fielded over 100 calls of someone in crisis since July of 2018. It's not the sort of police work that we've traditionally seen, but our goal remains the same, to respond to every call and to keep our city safe.
Our police levy stands at 55 cents per 1,000, and we need to take that up to 63 cents per 1,000 in the renewal. It's important because the cost of doing business is rising. The communication systems and being able to renew our communication systems with the county is going to cost a lot more than it did over the last 5 years.
Our officers are putting in more training, such as 40-hour crisis intervention course, to keep us and you safe. Addressing the growing demands and calls for service continue to be a focal point of the city administration and police department. Community safety and livability is paramount to our mission, and we will continue to strive to meet our goals of providing King City residents the very best service available.
This is important. We want to make sure that our community continues to understand how important these funds are, and we want to demonstrate to them that every time we ask for more money, that they can visibly see the results of it.
We have nearly 110 years of policing experience amongst our officers. It is our sincere hope that through investing in training, career opportunities, and assignments such as investigations, bicycle patrol, and mobile field force that we will be able to retain our staff for the long term and not lose them to neighboring agencies that can offer higher base salaries and incentives per month. It is a challenge to keep our highly trained officers, even though they love working here.
Now, we don't intend to add another officer just yet, and I think many people need to understand that we have now been approved to expand our city through our UGB request to Metro. And as a result of that, over the next 10 to 15 years, the city is going to grow tremendously. And we'll have to eventually look at adding officers. We want to have 24/7 coverage. And these kind of funds put us in a position to be able to do that.
Technology has become an even more important asset for our officers and our partner police departments here in Washington County. The costs associated with dispatching services, radios, mobile data terminals, report management systems, and licensing agreements has and will continue to increase since our last levy renewal. Our portion of dispatch services will rise well over 100% in the next 1 to 2 fiscal years. Without upgrades to our existing report management system, we won't be able to coordinate with our partner agencies, which could jeopardize investigations.
In order to serve our community, we have to keep pace with this. And I think our community is very pleased with the way we support them. We are a service-oriented police force. You know, a lot of our service is just making sure that the well-being of our community is there. We spend a lot of time making sure that we do welfare checks for our seniors and to really make sure that it's a safe community. And I think our community really appreciates that. But in order for us to be able to continue to do that, we need to make sure that we keep pace with the cost.
The revenues generated from the current levy have not kept up with general inflation, as the price of everyday equipment such as uniforms, fleet, fuel, and maintenance increase. Those costs have risen steadily over the past 10 years. In an effort to meet those needs and to provide service at current levels, we're asking for your help. We're having discussions in the city about priorities and demands for King City over the next 5 years. And it's likely we'll be discussing that levy and these funds. It is the honor and the privilege of my life to lead the King City Police Department, and for us as a department to serve so many great residents that call King City home. Thank you for making our officers feel like such a loved part of this community. We love serving you and keeping you safe.